Interested in learning how to add sprints to your Notion workspaces? Sprints are short work cycles, typically about 2 weeks, for completing specific goals and tasks. Notion has a built-in feature for this that behaves differently from typical databases. I'll show you how to set it up and what limitations to watch out for. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. To get started with sprints, you first need to have a task type database, and I wanted to show you all how to do this through a sample team space. Most likely you'll have a team space homepage, and then you'll want to add that task database by clicking the plus sign here to add it to that team space, and I'm going to click empty database. This one is going to be a tasks database, but we have to do one more step in order to be able to implement sprints, which is to click the settings and then go to more settings and then go to turn into tasks. For it to be a task type database, it's going to need an assignee, a status, and a due date. So I'm going to click turn into task database. And one of the benefits of a task type database is also that it's going to show up in your home in the sidebar. And you can have a list of global tasks across your entire workspace. Now that we have a task type database, the next step is going to be to go to more settings and then click sprints. And then we can click turn on sprints. And it's going to create a sprint board as well as a sprints page. And these two pages don't really act like a traditional Notion database or a page because they have built-in features in order for sprints to work. So just to explain this, I'm going to add some sample tasks inside my task list. And now let's say that I have these four tasks. So if I go over to my sprint board, right now I'm on sprint one and there are no tasks inside here. But if I click my backlog, I'm going to see all of my tasks here. And the backlog is basically showing all tasks that haven't been assigned any sprints. So the first step to doing this would be to go to sprint planning and then check the backlog and then start assigning them to different sprints. I'm going to assign this one to sprint one. And then I'll assign this final one to sprint two. And as you can see, the current sprint is sprint one, the next sprint is sprint two. If I click sprints, you'll see the current and then the next sprint. And this way you can plan for future sprints as well. So I could even add another one, which is sprint four. And this would also be a future sprint. If I open one of these, you can see all of the tasks in that sprint and then also see it by assignee as well as do some planning inside. So now if I go to my sprint board and I go to current sprint one, I'll see my tasks here. And let's say that during those 2 weeks that I have sprint one, I complete task two and three, but task four was unfinished. So when you're at the end of the cycle, you're going to click complete sprint and it's going to show you what the next sprint is going to be based on what you've assigned it. And then you can check the start and end dates for that. And then you can choose what to do with the one incomplete task, which is to move it to next sprint, move to backlog, or keep it in the current sprint. So I'm going to go ahead and complete sprint one by moving the one incomplete tasks into the next sprint. So now sprint two has started and I can see already that I have task four and task one in the not started list. If I go to sprint planning, the next sprint is going to be sprint three. Last sprint was sprint one and I can see any backlog tasks if I have any. If I go back to my sprints page, you can now see that the last was sprint one. The current one is this one, and then the next one is going to be sprint three. And then I can also see the timeline of how the sprints are with relation to each other. And one other thing you can adjust with the settings is by going to the settings icon here, go to more settings, sprints. And here you can see when the next sprint should start, the duration of each sprint, start on date, what do you usually do with incomplete tasks, and then you can also automate the sprints by toggling this on. Next, let's talk about the limitations for sprints. So the first thing that's a limitation with this feature, so even if I click this, I can't change it once the sprint has been created. The other thing is that I can't change the sprint statuses, so those are also locked. If I click edit property, you can see that they're all locked, and this is because this is a built-in feature that operates differently from typical Notion databases. And one of the big limitations that I feel with the built-in sprints feature in Notion is that you cannot share this as a template as well. So you can't build in the sprints feature into a template that you can duplicate into other people's workspaces. And that's why I also built the Ultimate Project and Task Manager Advanced Version Plus Sprints template, which I'll share in the description below. And this one doesn't rely on Notion's built-in sprints, but it's just built out using Notion's databases. And that gives you a lot more flexibility, ensures that it works the way that you want it to work. I recommend checking it out if you're interested. Thank you so much for watching. I've also linked additional video resources on project management with Notion in the description, so feel free to check those out. I'm also available to help you set up your project and task management systems for your own teams and businesses, and I've linked the discovery call below as well. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.